Hello and welcome to another episode of HARDplay. This is episode 2 of Resident Evil 5. As always, I'm your player 1, Michael, and player 2 today is Andy.
Hello.
You ready to not be terrible again?
Yeah, I'm going to back myself into the corner here this time.
It's a pretty good corner.
Yeah. I think that's what's happened in the last couple of deaths we've just got.
Yeah. Well, that one, I could see it coming because there was two guys running at me and I could only shoot one.
Oh, yeah.
And I foolishly shot the guy that wasn't swinging a machete. So then the guy with the machete got me.
I don't know if my accuracy is going to be terrible because it seems every time you shoot a dude, I've shot him as well.
So you're not sure whether you're a good shot?
I'm just making up excuses.
I'm just faster than you.
Yeah, probably.
Well, like, this because, like, you played, like, all the tons of Resident Evil 5 we played together was on the 360 with a controller, and you don't like the controller.
No, it's terrible with it.
But I'm, like, good with the controller, so I've got, like, tons more practice with the method I like.
Yeah.
So we played, like... My 360 save file has like 160, 170 hours on it.
Oh, the amount of hours we put into
Mercenaries,
yeah.
Which is ridiculous considering that like the campaign's only like 4 hours long.
Yeah.
Depending on like how you die and stuff. Because it was funny when I was so psyched for the PC release of RE4, I would like watch all sorts of reviews and stuff like that. Playing like the GameCube one and the PS2 one. And they said it was like a 40-hour campaign.
Yeah.
And I was like, that's really long. But my first playthrough of RE4 was like 40 hours long.
Yeah.
Like almost on the dot. And I was like, wow. And then my second playthrough was like 20. And now it's like, you beat it in 3 hours.
Yeah. I don't know. I reckon if I played this one on amateur.
Kurt, come in. The locals are
with all these weapons, I could probably get it done in a couple of hours.
Yeah.
You just run through it.
For sure. And so I don't know if it was like just because it's your first Resident Evil in this kind of style.
Got it. Just hope he gets
it. It's better that they grab you compared to swinging you, otherwise you're fucked.
Oh. Yeah.
Shot of them you can, yep. A lot of them you can get out without even like, getting hurt.
Oh, here's the XP.
It's down. Oh. Oh, this is a good spot. No, he's dead already.
Yeah. Well, you want to go up that building?
I'll just get away from here. Because they come out too many ways there. Pick up his bracelet.
Yep.
Then monies.
Yeah, good. That's
see, I don't know if it was like if RE5, like if I hadn't played RE4 and RE5 was my first game like this, because you're like spending a lot more time, you're getting used to like how the shooting works and stuff like that, and you're exploring all the areas and looking for all the secrets and stuff like that. Like, maybe you would take more than 10 hours to beat this game, but like, yeah. I think first playthrough was like 8 hours on this one.
The very first time.
Yeah.
I think.
I love it when they're jumping off of something, so you shoot them and they just like don't look like they're taking damage, but the second they land, they just stand there for a second and collapse. Problem is you can't just like you think it would be faster if you kill the executioner then. Like, but this sequence just takes as long as it does, no matter what.
Yeah. They ever come up that ladder?
They do, but they're just killing
them.
We're
getting
too fast
to them before.
I think they can also climb up over.
Just where we're shooting from, I think.
I think so. We had one guy try to get up here so far.
We've got a hold out till Kurt gets here.
One guy came up the ladder. This is a perfect place to use my sniper rifle.
It is. Sniping with a Desert Eagle. Alright.
Whoops. I missed that time.
Yeah,
chunks of skull everywhere. This is a really good setup because we can see each other's screens.
Yeah.
So it is like split screen. Hey, there's one.
Oh, got him.
Yep.
Damn it.
Yep, that was mine.
Well, I'm gonna...
I remember playing the section and, you know, that being that electricity thing that you can shoot off?
Yeah.
And I did that once and I was like, oh, I know that's going to be an achievement.
Yeah, it is.
I bet it is. And then it totally was.
Yeah.
I got almost every achievement on the 360. But then they released the Versus mode.
Yeah.
And the Versus mode has, like, dumb achievements. It's just, like, win this many fights and matches.
Yeah.
And, like... the lag is really bad in the Versus mode.
They must have known it wasn't going to be hugely successful or people weren't going to stick with it for too long. Because most of the achievements are, oh, win 10 matches. And it's like, well, that's not many.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It just felt really weird. And also, like, you don't, like, have your good loadout. Like, you can pick what character you are, but you only just start out with, like, a pistol.
Yeah.
And you have to run around the map and find the weapons. Gotta hold out till Kirk gets here.
Tough one.
I know. You can tell from the music, it's so like intense.
I'm gonna take out the
door. Executioner doesn't do spawn. Is that a thing? Oh, there we go.
Take cover!
Ah, Kirk. It's pretty cool. Oh, I reckon the guy in, is it Mike, the chopper pilot at the end of RE4? He's probably cooler. For shame.
Nice. Oh, that accuracy.
Yeah, yeah.
Clear time, how are you even meant to improve on that? Oh, that's because we died.
We died a bunch of times. We went way faster. Well, it only took us 7 minutes this time round.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. Instead of 14 minutes, it could have taken us 7.
Kirk, we owe you one.
You can thank me later. Chris, Sheva, it's almost time for Alpha Team to go in. Hurry to the deal coordinates.
Roger that.
For the longest time, every playthrough, I'd jump down there thinking that was the way to go.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I'd jump down there a couple of times.
Yeah.
And just be like, oh, wait, there's nothing good here. I think there's just a green herb over there.
I don't need to go up there.
No, you don't need to. Yeah, we get it. We get it! Oh, that's right. It was giving you the skip prompt. Can I shoot this guy? Oh, yeah, there. Just stuff getting in the way.
Yeah, you need to turn up here, don't you?
Alpha team!
Yeah.
Do you copy?
Well, do you even?
No, you don't. But this will get you the key that will get you to the shotgun.
Yeah.
But we don't need that. We give a shit. If we want the shotgun, we'll equip it in our inventory.
Oh. Don't scare me.
Well, jump stairs tend to stop scaring you when you've beaten the game over 10 times.
Oh, shit. What a madman. Attacking at us without a head.
I thought he was around that corner. Oh, that's right, we actually don't even need to go through this building.
Yeah.
Hurry up!
Okay.
That'd get old.
When I first saw this, I thought this was like Ashley.
Help! Somebody help me!
Just the way that she's yelling help. Yeah.
Chris, help! got so sick of that by the end of Resident Evil 4.
Mm.
And she's the only one skinned like that as well.
Yeah. That's the thing, people like... Hey, what's people wrong? Hate on this game about Sheva because she's like useless and stuff.
Yeah.
But that's just like the AI being useless.
Yeah.
But like Ashley is like equally as annoying.
She's the worst. She's just a hassle constantly.
Well, like Sheva, you can at least like, if you don't want her to use up all your ammo, you just like
don't give her any. Yeah.
Or just give her a different weapon.
Or just give them no weapons. Just make them a mule.
Yeah, I've done that. Boom. Because like besides professional, she is pretty good at like just healing you.
Yeah.
One of the achievements that took me so long to get was because, like, whenever you heal her, she automatically says thanks.
Yeah.
But you actually, if you click B just directly after, or whatever your keyboard one is for talking to your partner, if you hit it right after they heal you, you'll say thanks to them. And there's an achievement for developing, like, a bond with them that's basically just like, yeah, you need to say thanks to them, like, a bazillion times. Oh, shit, there's a guy behind us. So that one, it took me almost like an entire second playthrough of the game of saying thanks when she healed me
to get the achievement.
To get the achievement.
I don't think I've ever responded when they've given me something. I'm just not grateful.
Yeah, why would you?
Ugh, sticky icky.
That effect looks really cool as well. The goop running. And also, like, you can stand under it and it goes...
Yeah.
Giving myself a wash.
This guy who just stumbles around the corner.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that got me big time the first time. My first playthrough.
You can miss it really easily.
You're just running around.
Well, you can like cue the event up, but then also like just turn around and not look.
Yeah.
And it'll have you shot the medal yet? The emblem? Yeah, nice. So it's really easy to miss, and then you just go around the corner and he's already lying down there.
Yeah.
So I don't think I actually saw it on my first one through.
Okay.
So, but then it really got me on the second time because I didn't remember it happening.
No.
Hey, who did this?
Something attacked us. Irving. He got away. It was a setup.
A setup? What is this?
It's a hard drive.
It's huge.
It's a massive hard drive.
I downloaded it from their computer. Oh, you gotta get it to HQ.
Hey, hang in there.
He says it so casually. It's like he doesn't really care. He's just like, hey, nah, come on, hang in there. Oh, you're not gonna? Okay, I guess. I don't care.
He was expendable anyway. But they ran away. Chris knew it.
Oh, it's better Chris being like accepting that they're expendable than Chris in RE6 that gets fucking shitty, depressed, and acting like an idiot after like every person in his team dies.
I did not like Resident Evil 6 at all.
I like a lot of Resident Evil 6, but there's also a lot that I don't like.
Yeah.
And Chris's campaign is one of them.
I just think
everything that Chris
the gameplay
says,
didn't seem quite as refined.
No, it didn't feel as good. Like, it felt really loose. Yeah. I prefer, like, the tankier controls. So I like with Revelations 2 is that they go back to a nice, like, in-between 5 and 6.
Yeah.
That, like, I really like.
I haven't played the second Revelations. I think I played through first episode. But I don't like the whole whipping out the torch to find items thing.
I am.
I'm not a fan of that because then you're just sort of searching constantly.
It's a funny mix if you're playing it single player.
Yeah.
But playing it split screen co-op is really good because then like one character has a specifically different role to do because like their melee is like twice as strong as Claire's melee, but they don't use guns. Well, Moira doesn't use guns, but then she can find the items. And you've got like a pretty classic Resident Evil item screen. That's like more old school than like this one here with the 9 squares is pretty much like like RE1, 2, and 3.
Yeah.
But instead of having like 8 slots, you got 9. And like the game doesn't pause while you use it. Which I really like the compromise of what the item system is to be in this game, so that you can, you've got like the 4 items that get mapped to your D-pad, depending on what slot you put them in the inventory with.
Yeah, well, on keyboard, it's just use the number keys. So
one through 9.
At the top. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's good as well, but like...
the furnace, or just up here?
Nah, we'll just shoot him.
That's what got Alpha team.
It's so much easier.
Yeah.
But yeah, so in RE4, like, the attaché case thing is fun, but then, like, there's no quick select weapons. I don't know. I don't know if that was the rocket or if it was my shot that killed him. The rocket launcher is not a one-hit kill for all the bosses, is it?
I think it's most... the crab thing, you got to get it to open its mouth
first. Oh, yeah. Because I know that the dumb Los Plagas laser thing that was in RE4, it was like literally like a one-hit kill for every single boss.
Yeah.
It was just ridiculous. When I do the RE4 hard play, because I'm going to do a hard play of every single Resident Evil game, because it's so fucking awesome. And I don't know why I've waited like a year of doing the channel to actually... like, finally do a Resident Evil game. Because they're the best.
Especially number 5. Like, I don't think it was the most popular one for everyone, but I could play it over and over and over again. And
it's
because
it's got the co-op in it.
Yeah.
Like, there's that... like, I really... like, 4's probably my favourite, but there's something about 5 that I like that 4 doesn't have.
Yeah. I know it's good for... like completionists, I suppose, because there's so many. You got to play through so many times to unlock everything.
There's a really robust unlock system and stuff.
Considering what it did to Alpha Team,
compared to an RE4, where there's just like a couple of New Game Plus weapons that have unlimited ammo.
Yeah.
Like, it's just like not everyone you can unlock to be unlimited and stuff. But like every game is like way better with co-op.
Yeah.
Excellent work out there. We'll analyze. I remember losing my shit.
This whole town's gone to
when
hell.
He says this line.
The people here, they're acting like those Ganado detailed in the Kennedy report.
Yep, I remember
like,
that in the trailer.
Like, oh my god, Chris said Leon's name!
Our transportation has been...
oh my god!
Requesting a mission update.
When the trailer came out for Resident Evil 6, and you see them pointing the guns at each other, I was so rowdy for that.
Yeah.
Brent's a bit anticlimactic in the game. You want us
to go in there alone? I think it's because they showed it off in the trailer.
Yeah.
Look, that cutscene's like one of the best cutscenes in the game. And it's like the only time that Chris actually isn't like freaking like annoying.
Moping about.
Yeah. And it's like, imagine a game where like Leon and Chris are like partners through the whole thing. And that would just be amazing. And like the banter they would have would be ridiculous. Where it's like every line of dialogue that Chris says in RE6 is like fucking awful and so annoying. But then like Leon shows up and oh, you did slightly better than me. Nice. Congratulations.
Cop it.
I will.
Oh, that's the mouse. Just got to click on people. I didn't pick anything up.
But no, I'm good. But yeah, like that one cutscene that like Chris talks to Leon in, it's like, oh, Chris, I can stand Chris. He sounds all right. And then he just goes back to being like mopey and stuff.
Yeah.
Although actually it's not all of his dialogue as so much. I found I was on the Resident Evil modding boards and someone reskinned Chris's face. So his like angry expression is textured onto his face in RE6.
Yeah.
So someone recreated the texture so that his like eyebrows aren't constantly like tensed and stuff like that,
okay.
And his cheek muscles aren't all tensed and he's looking angry. And he basically looks like he is in RE5 again. And I've replayed all of Chris's campaign with that mod on, and it makes the cutscenes less irritating.
Yeah, okay.
Because his face doesn't... I didn't really, like, know what it was before and, like, how to describe it, but, like, that's, like, yeah, it's just, like, his resting bitch face, essentially. And someone's made a mod to give his RE5 hair in RE6, but it doesn't work in cutscenes.
No, okay.
Like whenever he moves his head, it kind of like it like shifts and loses. It just like doesn't stay there. But like I think like Leon's campaign in RE5 is pretty good. In RE6, it's pretty good. There's not like the last chapter's a bit annoying because you fight like 7 bosses in a row, or it's like the same boss over and over again. Which is you just keep killing and coming back. Like he comes back like 5 times in that one chapter. But like yeah, Leon's campaign overall is pretty good. It's got that like really good dark spooky atmosphere that like say we were talking about with the Lost in Nightmares had.
Yeah.
And the C-Virus zombies I liked fighting because they're like basically like classic zombies, just with like their little differences. But yeah, like I think. People hate on that game a little bit too much, I think. I think it's pretty impressive that there was like 4 whole different campaigns and each one of them is like 5 hours long. Help me. Like, there was a lot of Resident Evil in there, and like, even though some of the game isn't very enjoyable to play, like, the actual, like, plot of the game and all of the lore that, like, all of the events that happen and stuff like that, yeah. I like that canon. And that it should, like, stay... Like, those events are cool events, like... They finally went back to, like, a, like a big city again.
Yeah, bigger scale.
Instead of just, like, the little... Like, oh, we're off in Spain somewhere, or yeah, we're off in Africa somewhere.
It's a bigger scale, catastrophe, sort of.
Yeah. Like, it's, like, the Raccoon City again, sort of thing.
Come on!
What?
Oh, man, this moment...
I fail this so frequently.
It's so bad. Yeah. I can never remember whether you're supposed to hit... touche, sir. Yeah. And I had a green herb sitting there already. I can never remember whether to shoot him or the truck.
I think you can do both. There's an achievement for shooting him, but I haven't got it, but I've passed this bit, so...
I think...
Yeah.
Oh, we don't need to both jump down. RPG, just RPG.
I don't think that works, though. Oh,
nailed it! Nice. It's funny because like last time we played this, we died like 6 times in a row doing this. You totally hit that guy, like twice.
I think I might have missed just.
No, I could. On my screen, I could see the blood, like effect from the bullet shot, twice.
I haven't made any of this common. Anybody able to sort of survive Lightning Hawk?
Yep. He's the real hero of RE5.
Yeah, there's my hand in.
Yep. Nailed it.
Yeah, the dogs
are like, yeah, they do. They annoy me too. I don't like it. And like Mercenaries in RE6 is pretty awesome. There's some good stages. And I love that like they brought back Sherry as like an older character that's like a playable character now.
Yeah.
And she was awesome. Yeah, I feel like everyone was like hating on RE5 versus RE4, and then like when RE6 came out, everyone's like, oh, RE5 was so good, why can't it be like that? And it's like, but you were like complaining about RE5.
It's just a classic popular thing.
Yeah.
Something's coming. Watch out!
You shot him and the other at the same time. Oh my god, I got stuck up there.
Oh, look at her just palpating. That's disgusting. What a fiend.
We're making great progress now.
Yeah. I was sort of when there's the huge hordes enclosed in spaces. Oh, when we start getting shot at, that's going
to
be tough.
Oh man, that's going to be really bad. We're probably actually going to have to take our time and actually use the bad cover system.
Yeah, finally got my green herb.
Well, fuck you.
Hey, I didn't know this building existed.
What's really?
Oh, another herb. I don't know.
Such a noob, man.
I know. I probably played through this game at least 10 times. What's wrong with me?
For sure.
race for the red hair.
Yeah, that's all. Like, when I was saying that we have, like my 360 save says 160 hours, like, considering that the game campaign itself doesn't take that long, and... Oh, I forgot that there was one in there.
Yeah.
Nice. And that Mercenaries is only, like, 5-10-minute rounds.
Yeah.
That's, like, a lot. Like, a lot, a lot. Like... 160 hours isn't a lot compared to some MMOs. I'll say, like, Witcher 3, I totally played for, like, 200 hours. My first playthrough, doing, like, 100%. Bring it on. This is an easy call. Really fucking easy call.
Well, yeah, these bits are really easy, because there's only two directions or so they can come
from. Yeah, that's so the thing. That first building in the public assembly area is, like... There's like four different areas that can come through. There's like the roof, there's like the way we entered, and then there's the gate, and then there's like around the side, over the fence as well. Well, this is when people start shooting us, but with crossbows. Crossbows aren't as difficult. No, I'm not going to bother with those boxes. Also, Kirk can be a shit here and, like, hit with an RPG.
You got to sort of take your time with it.
Yeah. You can't rush it otherwise. Yeah, he'll shoot ahead and murder you.
You two okay? HQ sent me in to provide air support. It's gonna get hot down here, so watch out.
Roger. I'm just gonna bomb the place.
Wow. I didn't think HQ actually
did. I'm good.
That was so close, Steve.
I'm so fine. Doesn't even make sense that he would shoot there at all. No. There was never any enemies
there. Oh, there's another
one
floating. Look at it just twist.
Oh, it did the exact same thing. That hit, like, right in front of you.
Yeah.
I don't know why he's shooting down there. What are they doing?
Okay.
He's going to do it again.
Yeah, the helicopter hasn't moved on. But we need to move on.
Maybe. I think going up here is pretty safe.
Yeah,
I don't think they ever shoot up here. Again, yep, that's right.
Well, there's herbs for days.
Yeah. Everyone's dead. Stop. You're making me nervous, helicopter.
They all bust out.
Man, I really want Resident Evil 7 right about now.
Has there been any announcements on news?
There's been nothing. And, that crappy Umbrella Corps game was supposed to come out like this month or next month, but it's been pushed. It was supposed to come out in May, I think, but it's been pushed back till June.
Yeah.
So we're probably not going to hear anything. Like, they're not going to announce the next Resident Evil game until they release the one that they've already announced.
Yeah.
So they're going to, like, there won't be any news until that one comes out. And that one doesn't look very good at all.
The helicopter's still laying low.
Yeah, I think he's glitching out.
But he's not going to shoot us if we run to
it.
No, it's fine. That was the really weird thing with RE6. Like, they like, publicly, like, sort of said in a statement, like, they were trying to go more action gamey. Like,
yeah.
Like, RE5 was a lot more action gamey, but then they were trying to sort of chase the Call of Duty sort of success.
Yeah.
And you can kind of tell from some of the campaign sections in RE6 that they're trying to go very, like, Modern Warfare 3-ish in, like, some of the cutscenes. But then they said, like, because it was so unpopular. That's funny, like, we both get different shots of that cutscene. Yeah. And that happens in split screen as well. If you're playing and one person walks up, you'll get two different camera angles. Yeah, then, like, after, like, you know, RE6 got a lot of hate and stuff and wasn't, like, didn't get received that well, they said, like, oh, yeah, sorry, we, like, understand that, like, fans want to see something more. Oh, shit.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that was my bad. Castro got me.
Yeah. It's definitely Luigi. Luigi without his hat.
Soviet Luigi. Yeah, they said, like, oh, yeah, we get that, like, you know, people want a Resident Evil game and this wasn't sort of the right thing, and so we'll go back to more, like, what the series is. And then they released Revelations 2, which totally was like more like a classic survival horror game. And I really, really like Revelations 2. But then they were like, oh yeah, but here's our like first-person slash third-person shooter that's a Call of Duty like 3v3 online game.
Yeah.
It's a cover-based shooter. And it's like, wait, what? Well, I thought you said you weren't. I thought you said you were doing more... going back to what makes Resident Evil Resident Evil.
I don't know, I'd be happy if they like worked on a couple of remakes.
Well, they are doing remake 2. That,
like,
that has been
the way
confirmed.
They've done the HD remakes, or like this kind of gameplay with Resident Evil 2.
That would be fun. Like, I know that would be like that's blasphemy among like a lot of fans.
Well, they haven't changed the gameplay, huh?
Yeah. Like, there's lots of fans of the traditional survival horror ones that like don't want to play RE1 or 2 with over the shoulder.
I think
so too. I think that the environments, like the level design of the classic Resident Evil games, is way more fun than like the fuck.
What? Yeah,
it was hiding around the corner. Or you don't need to jump up there at all.
No, it does help a little bit. Otherwise, they can run down and start shooting arrows at you.
Yeah, that's true. But if we just stick together, it'll probably be easier. The level sort of layout in 4 and 5, I think, isn't as well suited to this camera angle as what like RE1 and 2 is. Because like when you play that Lost in Nightmares and you're in like the hallways of the mansion, that's like it's really cool, like limited field of vision and stuff like that. You can't see around corners, and so like shit can actually like pop out and scare you. And I can imagine playing, like, everyone, like, flinches, like, with headshots or leg shots in RE4 and 5, but, like, you'd imagine if they did a remake of 1 or 2 with it, they wouldn't, like, you could, classic T-Virus zombies, like, wouldn't, like, respond to the pain like that. Like, you could just shoot them in, like, the legs and they, like, would just keep going and stuff, and they wouldn't flinch to kind of give you that melee opening.
Oh, yeah.
I think... the best compromise, like, some people would still, like, hate it and be like, oh, they should never do it, but, like, so the RE1 and 0 is pre-rendered backgrounds, but with the RE2 remake, like, they could make it look as good or better than RE1 remake with real time, and if it was all in real time, you could have the option to do either and just switch back and forths, and then it's just like, well, if you just give them the choice, you can play with the set fixed camera angles or with third person, then
that'd be
like
good. That'd be a good compromise because it'd be interesting to play through both of them.
Well, you would presume that they would like rebalance some of the enemies, the way the enemies work if it was over the shoulder, because with the fixed camera angle, you can't really, like, it's difficult to get headshots. You can kind of like with the shotgun, you can wait until they get up like real close and aim upwards, and you'll get like blow their heads off with like, one shot.
Yeah.
But if you just like nailing him in the chest with the pistol, you'd imagine that they would make the enemies harder in third person, but then you could like deal more damage if you're getting like critical hits with like the headshots and stuff.
Yeah.
Alrighty, now this section.
I know I have a BSA emblem behind me.
Yep, and also you can't get hit.
Yes.
Otherwise you're stuffed. But it's a good thing that I have.
They pretty much just come up the stairs.
Pretty much. And I have L sniper rifle. There's another one. Alright, just shoot the shoot gate lock.
There we go. Alright. I'll come over and shoot you.
Yep. Find Chainsaw Man. I remember Chainsaw Man was so hard to take down as well.
Yeah.
Like, you'd be, like, running loops around through the building because you'd be chasing, and you'd use, like, every grenade in the location and the explodable...
got the Transformer things. Buff.
And that one as well. Now it's just, like, bang, bang, bang.
Yeah. Does he resurrect?
I can't remember. I think he might on this difficulty.
I can't remember. Is it the...
It's funny, this hallway, this actually has different cutscenes depending on whether both of us walk up... the hallway, or whether just Sheva walks up, or just Chris.
Oh, he looks so good.
It's pretty awesome. That was the thing with, like, people complaining about RE4 and 5 being more action-based. It's like, the Resident Evil games are never really scary. There was just a couple of good jump scares.
Yeah. It was more the tense feeling.
Yeah, his chainsaw's still moving. Yeah. He's getting up.
It was more the tense feeling of not having ammo and having to conserve.
Yeah. And that's the thing, and that's what RE4 did really well, was, like, running away from the chainsaw man was, like, super, like, when you could hear that sound effect coming. Yeah, he's dead. Slit your throat with my fucking machete.
Yeah, and I've got some tiny little, like, 2-inch blade.
No, it's a pretty cool knife. When you look at the actual shape of it, it's pretty sweet. Like, if you turn around, it's a pretty cool knife.
I've forgotten how to even pull out the knife. What am I doing?
I don't know how you do it.
I was doing it. Oh, spacebar, there we go. I'm an idiot.
Yeah, see, that's...
Oh, yeah, it's not too bad, I suppose. Just pretty, in comparison to yours.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah. What I really want is Krauser's knife.
Oh, man, I want Krauser's knife. I've seen a lot of people do replicas online and stuff, but, like, they don't really get the shape right.
And I want that snake symbol or whatever it is that has at the base of it.
Yeah. I've seen a good one with that on it, but I think most of the replicas, like, they're really shitty quality steel.
Yeah.
Like, from some of the YouTubers that I've watched that do, like, knife reviews and sword reviews and stuff, they say that, like, the the edge is, like, really soft because it's not done with, like, a good grade metal.
I don't know. I'd probably have it just to have them crack reviews. Though.
That's true. It's not like we'll probably ever use it, really, but... Yeah. QTE! Oh, you actually get a thing telling you.
Yeah.
I guess I'll probably see that too when it's time for you to shoot with the chain.
That bit's brutal if you miss it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Really fucking brutal. Yeah. It's funny, this was one of the scenes that's in the making of that they show how they previs and stuff.
Yeah.
Where they shoot it with, like, live action stuff as well. And it looks so shitty when they do live action, like... But it basically looks as shitty as how they tried to recreate the action scenes in the Resident Evil movie.
Yeah.
But then, like, they just use that as a guide for when they're doing the motion capture and the animation, and it turns out it looks so fucking cool.
Because they'd speed it up, no doubt, and they've also got the frantic camera.
Yeah. And this is so cool when you see the slow-mo bullet thing.
Yeah.
On that realized.
Damn.
That's right, that's here. It's like, look at the bullet, it's spinning! Yeah. And that the little bit of, like, you can see that it's part of his shirt's on fire.
Yeah.
Looks so good. Like, yeah, this game is still super fucking pretty. I remember, like, years and years after this, there was, like, so many games came out and I was just like, it's still not prettier than Resident Evil.
Nah.
Looks so good.
Man, am I glad to see you guys.
Delta Team Captain Stone.
Chris Redfield.
Shiva.
Thanks, Josh. I owe you one.
You guys know each other.
I trained under Josh. He taught me everything I know.
Shiva became little sister of the team. Now, Shiva, you must continue your search for Irvin. According to the data we retrieved from the hard drive, we believe he has moved on to the mining area.
Yeah, he's going to appropriate his storage device.
Yeah, that's just straight up an SD card.
Yeah. Business here. And keep your radio handy just in case.
Thanks, Josh.
Look at that. Boom.
Jill. Thank you.
Are you all right?
This picture, it's...
I remember that they teased that image of Jill, like, in the liquid tube.
Let's move out.
In hibernation, like, in one of the first trailers. And it was really unclear, because you're like, who's that blonde lady?
Yeah, I remember that. I was super confused.
I was like, is that Ashley? Been captured again or something? You got much better accuracy than me. You're killing way more of the people. Well, we haven't been needing to use most of our healing.
No.
Shit yet.
I think I've used one first aid spray that I actually had to use. The rest of the time I've just sprayed it on a dead body.
Yep.
Sheva, you know where the
but then it doesn't
are?
Count anyway, because then you respawn.
Yep.
Not too far from
here. These dogs are a fucking pain in the ass.
Oh, yeah.
And the...
You know what?
Do it.
You can trigger them.
All right, I'll trigger them.
Yeah. Oh shit. Yeah, I panicked. It worked out there.
That's fine.
Now these guys are tough because you sort of have to take them out one at a time. If you just jump up straight.
More dogs. Boom, boom.
Oh,
that got both of us!
Oh.
Oh my! Double kill!
Damn, that was OP.
That was brutal ass.
Yeah. I'll keep my ass straight next time.
Yeah.
Sheva, do you know where the mines are?
Plaza Station. Not too far from here. Follow me.
Is that echoing for you?
No.
Oh, my audio, that was echoing.
That's weird. Nice. Sheva looks way cooler holding RPG than Chris.
Now, I'll keep my eyes front, you get the ones that come out behind.
Uh-huh. I got them both with the one hit. Oh, here they come this way. Okay. Oh, that's not a dog.
No.
That's a fucking, what do you call it? Hyena.
Yeah.
This is where I'd always do the achievement to, did you kill the thing that was flying?
Yep.
Cool. And he didn't spawn another one. Is there one more guy up here, though?
Yeah, there is.
Yeah. That's where I would always do the, like, deflect an arrow with your knife.
Oh, okay. I haven't got that yet.
That one's worth a lot. I remember on 360 it was worth, like...
Oh, I was going to say, use your handgun, take it in turns trying to get it.
Okay. I reckon...
You go first.
Can't see the dot.
No.
Oops. Alright.
Oh, mine probably won't be quite as hard. Oh, damn it. Arrogant.
Yep. Oh, that was right on it. You're okay. Yes. Nailed it.
Nice.
Could have RPG'd it.
Yeah, bit of an overkill.
A little bit. Do you want to just RPG the landmines down here?
Can you do that?
You can get a couple at least. I think if you just shot it.
Yeah, probably could. I can see one. Can I go through that? Okay.
Yes.
Bang another couple down there.
Got him.
Oh, that was useless. Alright, I'm gonna try that. You wanna jump down?
I think I see. Yeah, I'll jump
down.
Yeah,
you got that one, I think.
Yeah, we're clear. What do you think this is? Donkey Kong? That would be so funny. I was going to say that would be so funny if there was a minecart level, but then, like, that basically is what RE4 was.
Yeah.
But how is Donkey Kong jumping? How does he jump? He's jumping with the, So we're going to go slow with this one. Fuck it up. Yeah, this is, like, the only part of the game that's actually, like, dark. And this is basically what Revelations 2 is. What it says the torch.
This, yeah.
I have a, yeah. I think we get some flashbangs up here, which are good. Then again, I guess we got hand cannons.
Yeah, you pretty much just hit him once. This is one thing that the AI was pretty good at.
Yeah, it was excellent, because whenever you would aim, they would shine the torch and it would lock onto what you were aiming. It's a me!
Yeah.
Too easy.
Snakes coming out of here.
No. But just in case I swing twice. The skull. Shattered with my knife. That is straight up just the RE4 barrel.
Oh, yeah.
Which is still in Revelations 2 as well.
I don't know, why fix something that isn't broke?
That's right. That was one of the things I enjoyed. Yep. We got a jewel up here. Yeah, I like how, like, there was the achievement to get all the jewels, and there's just, like, four or five in the game that are, like, unique ones that you only find in that one spot.
Yeah. How do you get the one? I've never got the one in the volcano.
The white heart,
yeah.
I think, is the volcano one. I don't know. It's really hard to do without dying, because you have to... Basically, when you first fall down, you know, you're walking across and Sheva gets across, but Chris falls down.
Yeah.
With the crumbling rock. There's, like, a little section there that you can leap across and get the jewel, but then if Wesker will jump over there with you, and then you just can't get out, because he... I think Sheva maybe needs to shoot him to stun him.
Yeah.
So that you can
until
run
he jumps
past
up
him
and starts chasing Sheva.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Something like that. We can attempt it.
What? Oh.
When we get there.
Ooh, there's the shaft keeps going up there.
And that's the enemy spawn location for mercenaries.
This one's so bad for mercenaries because you'll have an awesome score on those shitty insect things that just come up.
Oh,
later.
I know.
If I drop this. No, I just put this up one way.
Yeah. Why are they not shooting at you? Or do they not come rock up until we both get in here?
No, not until we're both in.
Well, that's good.
Should we take cover somewhere? We get arrows out of there. Oh, there's a guy behind you.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, they jumped down, like, just above us. Man, I was so good with that bow. No laser point bow.
For what?
For mercenaries.
Oh, yeah.
Sheva with a bow.
Except I still have a crosshair.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I remember I had, like, a 60% accuracy on that weapon.
Yeah.
Oh shit. So easy.
Yeah, that wasn't too bad.
Also, I think, like, the levels in this are, like, as good as, like, a lot of the levels in RE4.
Yeah. What design on it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, although it's, like, oh, less dark and maybe less spooky than, like, the castle is, like, all the levels are pretty good.
I really like these bits where you just have, like, the big open area and tons of enemies coming at you.
Yeah.
Like, this bit in the assembly area, you just pretty much just need to hold off.
Yeah, that was fun. It was, like, that assembly area is, like, the recreation of the cabin section from RE4 when you're with Lewis. And they're all breaking
in.
Oh,
yeah.
Was there an emblem around here or something?
A what?
An emblem?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Does not work again. Oh, you're already up there.
Yep. Okay.
I don't need that handgun anymore.
Nope.
Get the fuck out of here.
Going up. Oh, we're inside of each other.
Yep.
Oh,
Oh, that light. My breath is really burning.
I know. This section is kind of cool when it's like dusk.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, Elegante shows up. But he's not Elegante. It's a different, gigantic, fucking mutated person.
Breathe! Oh, shit.
And Irving.
You must be Irving.
Irving, he's such a fiend. Look at him.
Wow. He's a very divisive character. I think that's one of the reasons why people hate this game a lot, because Irving, like, people can't stand him.
Yeah.
I'm a businessman with standards. How about you? It's funny, the actor who plays Irving looks exactly like him. Like, they just used his image for the character model. And it's really funny watching him do the motion capture.
Did you, when you played through it the first time, when did you realize that was Gil? Like, when there was the big reveal? Did you work it out?
I think it was the big reveal. I wasn't really thinking about it much.
No.
I, like, barely noticed that it was actually a woman from, like, the high heels and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
I remember when we first played it, you were like, is that Claire? And I was like, what? No. No, you meant Jill, but because you said Claire, I was just like, no, and told you that. And then when we got to the reveal, you were like, see, I told you.
Yeah, I was just
like,
an idiot.
You said Claire. And I was like, Claire's not in this game.
Just classic me, muddling up names all the time.
Yeah. And that paper folding over, that was some fucking next-gen shit.
The oiled field. That's in the marshlands.
Oh yeah, I guess that's the other thing that people don't like is, like, the marshlands and all of the Virginians start going, like, tribal with skirts and stuff and spears. We think he's
heading for an this is the bit where it's super useful to have a sniper rifle. Okay,
yeah, it is.
We're taking it out. Let's go downstairs and make a good plan, man.
Guy hasn't even noticed everyone's head's been popped.
Is there someone on the Gatling gun?
No.
No, I'll make a run for it then.
Yeah, there'll be another guy that'll run and try and get on the Gatling gun.
Yeah.
Missed him. Shit! Oh man.
You've been so close.
Yeah, I barely missed that pickaxe that he swung at me. Did you go out a different way than.
I went around
the side.
Yeah, yeah.
I never went around the side.
Yeah. Oh, there's like red belt up there.
Oh, you know it. Not even a toilet there. No. I guess that's like a squatting.
Squat block.
Look, it's got like feet mark. Like, this is where you put your feet. That's where you squat.
Yeah, I'm glad I don't have that. There's no shadow for the ladder here.
Yeah. Yeah, I love how this rifle looks on Chris's back.
Yeah. It
looks fucking sweet as.
I think the RPG is about as tall as Shadow.
Almost!
Close to, yeah.
She's probably only like a head taller.
Yeah.
So, well, I don't think we'll bother throwing you up the alternate route.
Nah.
I think we'll just go up the way we go.
Are we just gonna bolt through? Oh, he's already throwing stuff at us. He's keen.
Dead now.
We're just gonna bolt up because they just throw all the explosives at us.
Yeah, that's true. It's not that hard though.
Nah.
Because it's not like we actually really need to run past very many guys.
Nah.
Like, a lot of them are getting blown up by the bombs anyway. Sticks of TNT.
might hear something.
Oh, yeah.
Shit.
Oh, shit. And now they, like, start leaping down.
Yeah.
Look, this guy's all the way over there. Look, like, they're spawning from all the way over up here. Yep. That guy's just waiting. That weird albino guy. They added it into the hordes after people complained that they're all black.
That was a bit silly.
I think it's a bit silly, because they're like, oh, it's just a white guy shooting a bunch of black people, and I'm like, this game's made by Japanese people.
Yeah.
Like, it's...
Maybe there's just an influx in tourists over here when the Lost Plague hit.
Like, you can say the same about, like, all the white zombies. Or all the Spanish. Like, nobody cared that they were Spanish.
No.
That they had accents.
But if there was one, like, set in Asia somewhere and it was just Asians you were killing, no one would have cared.
Well, yeah, because, like, RE6 was like that. Like, most of it set in China.
Yeah.
Like, it's probably like 60% of, or like 60 to 80% of that game is fighting the Asian, what are they called? I forget what they're called. They're different to like the C-virus zombies.
Yeah.
Because they're the guys that have like injected themselves into it. And so they're the ones that like wear the funny masks and have machetes and stuff like that.
Mm.
And guns. I've forgotten the name. And this fucker.
Yeah.
This B.O.W.
Playing this the first time around is...
This is the section that gives you all of the landmines.
Yeah.
Looks like a new thing.
What is that?
Yep.
Do it.
Yeah, well, it's funny, like, with you're supposed to, like, hit it in its soft, glowy part, like, every Resident Evil enemy. But, you can shoot the shell with, like, hand cannons and it actually, like, does enough damage to hit him.
Did that not kill it?
Nope. See?
Nice. You
don't actually have to hit it in its gooey center.
It's a Nazgul.
Yep. That's such fucking badass shot.
Yeah.
Like, everything Chris does in RE5 is just, like, cool.
Yeah.
It's just, like, super cool. Non-stop. And then in RE6, it's not. Everything he does is fucking shit.
He'll be back. Or is it another one?
I think it's another one.
Chris! Shiva! Get in!
Yeah, yeah.
Now, this next one's... tough, because it doesn't matter what weapons you've unlocked, you've always got the same shitty gun.
Well, I remember, like, it always does, like, a really dumb thing, because, like, I would look, and my accuracy on this chain gun would be, like, 99% accurate, and I was like, I'm throwing bullets all over the place in this section, there's no way.
It's when you're fighting the big thing, you just load
that's true, you are loading it into him, and you, like, never miss then, so that probably, like, puts the percentage pretty high. It's like, I love that there's like those like sort of options that you can go through and look, and it'll be like, yeah, this is how many times you've shot this gun.
Yeah.
You've shot this many bullets out of this gun, and you've killed this many enemies with this gun, and you can go through every individual enemy.
Yeah, the way they've done the stats in this is really good.
It's really fun.
Yes, but there will be other opportunities. Sheva to headquarters.
But she's sitting in there.
Yeah, it looks like a suitcase.
That Irving is on his way to an oil field in the marshlands. We're rejoining Delta Team and heading there now.
Understood.
There's no way they didn't
let that happen, do they?
Kill those bikes flying that bar down.
What you gotta do to stop them? But don't get too trigger happy or the guns will overheat. If that happens, we'll be an easy target until they cool down.
It's like, can I just use the rocket launcher on my back?
I would like that very much.
Got sharp curves up ahead. Hold on tight.
I forgot about those.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, you'll get really fucked up, unprofessional, from missing these PTs.
Based on the data you uploaded from that hard drive, most of the targets are Proton's people have been infected by parasites known as Los Clarkas. The data refers to the infected as Magini.
And when you play your Shiver and you've got the chain gun, it takes a while for the battle to start spinning before you start shooting.
Yeah, there's much more of a delay than on this is like an M60 sort of.
Yeah.
Gun. It's not quite, is it? Oh, I didn't realize there was another truck here.
Hang on!
Did we both nail it? Yeah, we did. The problem is you can't fucking hit this guy. There we go. Oh man, I shot that Molotov out of the air so, like, last second. It's like right in front of my face. That was funny though, it was just like all six of those bikes were like doing the exact same animation.
Yeah.
They all fell off of it.
So that AI is horrible with this bit. Just missing every bullet in the AI.
Got some sharp curves up ahead! Hold on tight!
Yep. The only real difficult part is when they pull up at like the roadblock. So you just gotta like aim for the barrels. If it's like if I like start on the left side and then work on the right side and just move our way in, shooting those explosive barrels, you basically just take out everyone.
So I go left.
What did I say? I said I'll go left and you go right.
Says that.
I don't know. It's kind of hard to tell.
Well, it's kind of inappropriate for the situation.
Yep.
Alrighty.
Here we go.
There's no getting past that truck unless you two do something about it.
Yeah, that was pretty easy.
Yeah.
Really gonna keep. Gonna keep going, are you?
Okay.
They just keep running out from behind that truck. Yeah. It's like, is there really that many of you hiding behind that truck?
Nice.
I don't think so.
Axe. Get stuck real quick.
Yep.
He's trying to ram us into the river. Do something.
The section isn't that bad because, like, there's like that cliff. Side,
yeah,
on the one side they're gonna
ride down,
yeah.
What a massacre.
It would be funny if, like, in your kill count, there was like motorbikes destroyed.
Yeah.
Maybe an emblem in that section when you go over a bridge.
I don't think so. No,
no. I might be doing something else.
Oh, that's not possible.
No.
What is this fast and furious?
Ludicrous. It's like there was no ramp on one side. The cutscenes look really pretty when it's nighttime like this. There are no more orders from here on in.
What could have done this?
Elegante, that's what.
You just know that guy's fucked.
Mm-hmm. I noticed that those little bats that come through the window in Lost in Nightmares, you can actually shoot them. You don't get any points for them, but you can shoot them. So I wonder if they actually show up in your your enemy killed thing.
So I know when you kill... Is there only one vulture or so that's through the game?
Yeah.
I know that comes up in kills.
It's really rare.
Yeah.
And you got funny things like spiders and snakes. And
yeah.
Oh.
Is he dead?
It's guy has a belt.
Yeah. Wearing an impressive beard, too.
Yep. That's the Lost Vargas. It's a good thing you didn't throw away your Jeep. The guns on it.
Oh, yeah.
This boss fight is really easy.
Oh, it's a bit harder with professional to get the guys on the side.
Yeah. But it's like really easy to make them flinch and stuff.
It's the quick time events that.
Yeah, if you don't fail the QTEs, like it just like you just beat him. I love how his head just like vibrates.
Yeah.
You shoot him. It's so funny. Or is it here that there's an emblem somewhere?
Nah, I don't think there is one on this one.
That's probably not an emblem. Probably nothing. Yeah, you can just shoot this boulder and it just like gets destroyed.
Oh, that was pretty close.
Oh, yeah, no, nope, forgot to do that part. Is he only swinging at one of us?
I think it's both. Oh, we both get the same damage.
Yeah. Shared health bar. Uh-oh, mine's overheated. So I was being an idiot. That guy was just standing there that whole time. He wasn't even hitting us.
Oh, I was really overheated.
It's okay, it cools down during that cutscene.
Yeah, people are quite cool.
I am.
You get people yelling?
Yep.
Cool.
Pretty sure I didn't even click that.
Do only one of us need to get it?
Oh, no. It's like any attack that he'll do, as long as you have an overheated and you can shoot at him while he's like, winding up for it, you'll just make it flinch. Yeah, you keep shooting him, I'll shoot that. Oh. I'll shoot the crossbow guys. Oops.
Oh shit. That was a crossbow guy there.
Yeah.
We can just shoot the explosive barrel.
That was the problem. I already shot the explosive barrel, so he won't drop it. But if he goes to pick up the other one.
Yeah, I think only one of us need to get it. Never done that on professional without dying.
Awesome.
But I think I've had S rank for every map on every difficulty except for this one.
Oh, really?
Best I've got is A rank.
I think I've gotten S rank for every difficulty on the 360
version.
Or at least I got S rank for every professional.
Where are you, Josh?
he did.
Sheva, you don't have to do this.
The way he shows back up is so sus.
What about you?
Well, when he just creeps up on Jill. Yeah.
It also creeps up on them.
Oh, he does too, yeah.
Pretty sure he's actually evil.
Yeah.
He's going to be the villain.
A while back, I received some intel that my old partner was still alive. At first, I didn't know.
Could you imagine? That'd be pretty disappointing, to be honest.
When I saw the data file from Delta Team, I knew for sure.
I don't know, I never really liked Josh that much.
That woman in the data file. Are you even sure it's the same person?
We were partners. I'm sure.
Partners?
Wait! Wait! You're not going alone.
And RE5 has Wesker in it, which, like, RE4 doesn't.
Yeah, and he's just such a buff.
Wesker's just sitting there with his turtleneck, like, looking at his, like, satellites on RE4. And this one, he's got the fucking cool ass leather trench coat. Dying here.
Are you sure about which, even the live action version of Wesker, it looks a bit corny. It doesn't look quite as good.
No, the costume looks awful.
And the actor's got like no neck. He looks a bit chody.
He's got a wide face.
Yeah.
Copy that.
I reckon the second Resident Evil movie, that was pretty good. Like, Nemesis was pretty much perfect.
Yeah,
they just need to get rid of Alice.
Yeah, if you get rid of Alice, you've got Carlos, Jill, and the Nemesis, and it's basically just a Resident Evil 3 movie.
Yeah.
For the most part.